vulnerable mental health problems in children and young people. We don't know if we are seeing more, as in there are more numbers presenting, or whether actually children and young people are just better at telling us now. They're just saying it, they're showing us in a way that we didn't see previously. The five-year spending plans for child and adolescent mental health services are being designed at the moment. There is this $1.25 billion that government has given. By the way, it will only take up the total mental health spend on children and young people from 7 to 8% of the total budget, and the mental health budget is 11% of the health budget. There's the priority. If children were falling and dropping down with some horrendous physical illness, and we didn't know what it was, money would be parachuted in. Kids with mental health problems are on 1 in 5 are turned away, only 15% get talking therapy. 70% will get some kind of treatment, but generally when it's way too late. The thresholds for us to admit a child now into treatment are so high that fundamentally, if you're not kind of suicidal enough, you just got to kind of go away and come back when you are. That's where we are. And that's the struggle that you have. My advice to you is find good community organisations, good charities, perhaps private practitioners who you can have in the school. Look at place to be. It's a counselling service that goes into schools. I'm an ambassador for them. Look at Young Minds. There's great stuff for professionals on Young Minds. It's a great website for you guys as well. And also look at setting up some peer mentoring schemes in the school, how you can get kids to support each other and get those kids trained up by people like me to escalate issues. But the good news is we have an incredibly emotionally articulate generation, more so than I've ever seen in my 25 years of clinical practice. Social media might bring difficult things to kids and young people, but it's also, they are talking and they are telling us and they are showing us. And just like with the four young people who are much better than me and preceded me, if we don't listen to what they say, what they are warning us will come true. And actually, they are seeing it much more clearly than we are. So thank you for listening. I hope